crisp one.
Right.
Action.
Okay. So, describe wealth.
You guys. So today we are talking about family, legacy, and wealth. Wealth, and at least my definition of it is one, freedom, right? The ability to have control over your time, to be able to say, I want to do this with my time, I want to be there for my kids, I want to travel. It's just having that true freedom. But of course, number two, the always flip side of the coin is being able to have the resources that you need to not only survive, but to thrive, right? I think so. Survival, and a lot of us are living in that survival phase, is cool, right? But being able to really thrive, take yourselves and your family to the next level, I feel like is what comes with wealth.
I completely agree with the both of what you said, but what came to mind first when the question was asked was what you said about the freedom over your time. Because I feel like the thought of wealth, that's been like an evolution of my thought process. So I feel like at first, when I thought of wealth, I definitely thought of, like, you know, money, property, things like that, which are still, you know, symbols, or can be symbols of wealth.
Another podcast episode.
Exactly. But I think that what I'm now, like, striving for is the freedom over my time. I feel like that is invaluable to, like, be able to wake up and I truly can do whatever I want to do today. That's priceless. Absolutely priceless.
Okay. Describe family.
Go ahead, Queen.
Describe family. I think when we mentioned earlier about, like,
I'm sorry. Can you say, we're talking about family, legacy. Family, legacy, and wealth. Sorry, not just talking about wealth. That's
my fault. Got you.
So when we think about family, when we talked earlier about you know, love and our love. And what makes our love special is because we can both be very genuine.
And that's what was in my head too.
Yeah. I think your family is that group of people where there's no one else in the world, you know, that you can be yourself with. Family is that group of people that know, they know you're the true you, they know the good, they know the bad, they know the ugly. They know you, you know, well. And I think that you get to see each other evolve. You know, obviously, as if you're a parent to your child, you literally get to see them evolve from a fetus to a real person standing next to you, talking to you. Like, that's still crazy, and we get to experience that. Right. But I think that's how I would describe family. It's just those people you can just be your 100% self with. Because I feel like once you go out to the world, even when you're meeting friends, sometimes you put yourself in a way so that you can, you know, seem this way or seem that way to be able to meet people, where your family is like, look, we suck with each other regardless, so you can just be you. I think that's really cool.
Agreed. I don't think all blood family is 100% family. I don't think all people that you're not related to can't be your family. You know what I'm saying? Like, there's some friends in my life that know sides of me that my family has never still to this day seen. So I agree with what you're saying. They are authenticity, the people, blood related or not, that you're able to just be 100% you and have helped you evolve and helped you grow, I consider all those people family. Legacy, that's what we're here for. I feel like legacy is almost, I don't know if it was more important than wealth, but I feel like I put a lot of emphasis on the legacy aspect because I don't just want wealth if it doesn't come with the legacy.
Right.
And for me, the legacy is that story, that impact that is felt or that is heard long after I've or we've left this planet, left this universe, right? So to have the TH4 Center, to have our kids, Kendry, Delton, Dwight, Drone, Sage, like to have them on this earth giving that impact, and to have buildings on this planet, schools, healthcare centers like here that are creating impact way past us, to me, that is what true legacy is.
I think it's leaving a piece of yourself behind, not just for the sake of leaving it, but so that it, whatever you're about, all of the ideals, all of the, like I said, like the healthcare, the building wealth, like that doesn't need to stop just because we're not no longer in the world. Mm-mm. We want that to keep going. We want to be able to continue to help people even after we physically leave this earth.
Like, I can still listen to Crenshaw, Victory Lap, Bullets Got No Name On It, and still like get lessons that help me become more and more like an entrepreneur, like a leader that he is slash was. I feel like that is legacy. The fact that O.W. Gurley bought his 40 acres in Tulsa, Oklahoma, built Black Wall Street, and then now like I was able to learn about Black Wall Street, create a board game off of it, and now I'm able to almost create a legacy off of the legacy that someone else created as well, is like the trickle down or the momentum that legacy can start to have is creating impacts into different generations, into different lives as well.
Mm-hmm. Great. Why do you think that these three things, family, wealth, and legacy, are necessary?
I don't think they're 100% necessary, to be honest with you. Mm. I think they're necessary and that's what we want, but I don't feel like family is necessary. I don't think legacy and wealth are things that are necessarily needed to survive and be here on this planet. I feel like they're things that we want for our kids, and I think we're gonna make it mandatory. Like, I don't know what the word is. I'm gonna make it mandatory. Like, these businesses that we're building for you, we want you to be a part of building these businesses. We want you to be a part of this legacy and creating your own legacy as far as us. We want to make sure that you have wealth when you're growing up. Not only like the wealth that we're going to pass down to you through our life insurance, through our trust, through our intellectual property, but we want to make sure that you have your own wealth as well as you're creating.
We realize that we have visions that this sounds corny, but we want to make the world a better place, right, in our little small
be
ways.
Corny. Yeah, be corny.
You know, in our little small ways. And the way you do that is by leaving a legacy. Leaving a legacy for us doesn't happen unless you have a village around you, which is our family. And really what's making that possible is the wealth that we're building. So they all kind of like connect to each other. I agree. It's not required for survival, but for us, it is like literally built into the fabrics of everything we do, how we live our daily lives, and how we talk about our future, talk about our family. It's built in, so it's like a part of us.
Yeah. What do you want your legacy to say about your family?
We look at the Trump family, the Hilton family, the Rockefeller family, and I feel like each of them have a legacy in their own right, some good, some not so good, right? So I feel like I definitely want our legacy to have a 6 generations down. Hopefully you're still working out of not necessity, but because you want to work. Mm-hmm. But I want the name Walker to stand for one, Black excellence. Mm-hmm. So no matter what room you walk into, they know what you're about. They know the lineage that you come from. They know the royalty that you come from, like synonymous with the Montemus. Like, oh yeah, that's the Walker kingdom right there. We know about y'all. So one, the Black excellence side of it. But two, what the Queen was saying, I love that part, that no matter what you're doing, you are trying to pour into the community. You are trying to make the world, the community, someday the universe a better place. No matter what, how you do it, right? Whether it's through dancing with Beyonce, whether it's creating board games, creating documentaries, taking pictures, fashion, like whatever it is that you choose to do 6 generations from now or 1 generation from now, we want it to still be able to be a positive reflection and pour into the community.
So let me see if this is, when it comes to family legacy and wealth, what is one important takeaway?
I was with my loctician, Rosie, Garnish by Rosie, much love. And she said, your business, right? Your professionalism, what you do for income is like a rubber ball. Right, you can drop a rubber ball at any moment. It's not gonna get damaged. It will bounce right back. You can catch it, have a good time. Like we used to do that as kids, like have the rubber ball, all that good stuff. Whereas your family is like a glass ball. You can drop the glass ball, but there's definitely gonna be some type of damage. It might just be a chip, it might be a crack, but the more and more you keep on dropping this glass ball, the more damage you're gonna occur, and eventually it's probably just gonna break, right? So when you're making the decision, you need to, I would say, value family and take care of family above everything else. Like, we got a lot of things going on, but if the queen's like, hey, I need you as the husband, D'eVon, as my friend, D'eVon, as she said earlier, the extremely hilarious, funny D'eVon. That's, we can roll the tape. That's word for word. What?
I believe I said he was very funny.
Mm-mm, you said extreme. I remember. We even roll it back. Kendra, you know what's up. But I feel like you need to make sure that no matter what's going on, when family reaches out to you and then they need you to be that family member, you step up and you be that family member and you let the rubber ball go for a second and just know confidently that it will bounce back and you can catch that ball anytime.
I think that when it comes to family, it is so delicate in terms of like those, you know, those relationships. Not that things can't be like relationships can't be what's the word I'm looking for?
Delicate, strong, you know, like long lasting,
patched up or you know, improved or
healed, if something healed.
Yes, thank you. But I think that those relationships are very important because like I mentioned, like when you are in like your lowest point, like who do you go to? I'm not saying it's always family, but I feel like, no, I think it is family. I think whoever you go to when you're in that point is family. Whether it's blood, whether it's friends, whoever it is.
Family or a therapist.
right.
Or your barber.
Yep, but yeah, I think that I'm not speaking as a parent, but I'm speaking as a future parent. Gotta pay attention, especially when in those younger years, like that's a lot of the reason why we're grinding very hard right now, doing what we're doing, so that we can both be fully present once we have starting kids. And that's obviously, you know, if you, not knocking any other way that any other parent would do it, but we've decided for us, we want to be able to, I don't want to have to, you know, leave and go to work and then pick up my kid and come back. You're losing so much time. I want to be able to integrate, you know, time with my kids. I want to be able to be with them, especially in those younger years. Yes, like when they're the babies. Like I want to be with them that whole time. I want to see every little new facial movement that they're making, new laughs, new like sound. Like I don't want to miss any of that, because I feel like that's so important. And then that, it's such a small time frame in every child's life. Like you get like however many years before, or not even years, I mean the months before they start talking, and now you're trying to get them to stop.
Oh well, I'll be talking to y'all.
In a perfect world, where do you see yourselves in terms of family, legacy, and wealth?
In 10 years. So family, of course, want the five, right? I feel like this is, you know, maybe the fifth time this brought up. So we manifesting them five kids for sure. You know, want the ability, hopefully, not knock on wood, Lord willing, Grandy can meet all five of the great grandkids. I think that's been on her list for a while, and she almost bribed us to have kids early. Like, I want my great grandbabies right, now. Come right. on now. I was like, all right, Grandy, hold up now. What if I give you? No, Grandy, you can't bribe me.
A $500 cash bonus if you give me your grandchild
right.
in the next.
Right. Legacy wise, I feel like I want us to, you know, right now we have our businesses, but I want some bricks in 10 years. And by bricks, I mean like we have True Up Forever on a building. We have Black Wall Street, the board game, or Institute of Melanation on a building. I want my hand in some dirt and that we can start building on, like, because I feel like that's the legacy, right? Like our websites are cool, but you know, the internet's about to go to a whole new wave of the internet, and the www dots probably aren't gonna be around 50 years from now. But this land, the earth, the buildings that we can build, those are gonna be here hundreds of years from now. So I want us to get started into that part of the legacy. And then with the wealth, where I want us to be in 10 years is to have a very set plan, and we met with our folks last week, and we're gonna meet with them again next week, clear schedule, but a very set plan on how our transfer of wealth is gonna happen, right? I don't want any type of probate court. I don't want any type of people arguing over, oh, we get this, we get that. I don't want any of our kids like starting to ruin relationships over who gets what asset and money. So I want it very clear, a will and a living trust set up that says, this is how the money is going to be set up. Once you get married, this is what you get. Once you buy your first house, this is what you get. You have your first kid, this is what you get. This is what's set aside for your college. Like all that needs to be laid out so that we can, die in peace whenever that comes when we're 200 years old. Just go ahead in peace knowing that our wealth is going to be successfully and smoothly transitioned to the next generation or two.
Ditto. I want our in 10 years, our kids are still going to be young, but I still want them to be like cultured in terms of like being able to travel the world. Like I want my kids to know what some authentic Thai curry tastes like.
Hopefully they like it more than you did.
Hopefully y'all ain't got my averse to lemongrass. I think that's just literally the only thing that I would add that you didn't already travel. Touch. Yeah. Other than that, I think you killed it. Oh, sorry.
You know, a little bit of scratch with the love. Ooh, and some kisses. All right, well, I'm with that. Y'all get that? Come on, man.